Bible study the Lord God allowed us to have at the Isle of Patmos Baptist Church. Let us pray. Heavenly Father God, in the blessed name of our Lord and Savior Jesus, we come, Lord, to thank you for your love, for your grace, and for your mercy, Lord God. We thank you for salvation. Sending your only begotten Son, Jesus, to die in the place of our sins that we may have a right to the tree of life, Lord God. We just thank you. Lord God, right now we pray that your Spirit will come and minister to us. Teach us what we should know about your words that we'll keep in our hearts. And go out into this sin-sick world and share your love, your words with others, that they may call on you to be saved. And Lord God, they know you, that they may just have a closer relationship with you, or a closer walk with you, Lord God. We ask you this prayer in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Yes. Yes. Welcome to another virtual Bible study of the Isle of Patmos Baptist Church, located on the corner of 12th and Rhode Island Avenue, Northeast, Washington, D.C., where our pastor of the Isle of Patmos Baptist Church is Bishop Calvin L. Matthews. Come and hear what thus says the Lord God through our pastor, Bishop Calvin L. Matthews. You all are welcome to the house of the Lord at the Isle of Patmos Baptist Church. Amen. Amen. Today, the Lord God allow us to be in chapter 6 of the book of Joshua. Yes, Joshua, chapter 6. I have the NIV Bible in front of me, and it's known as the New International Version of the Bible. Yes, that's what I'll be reading from. And that's Joshua chapter 6. The Lord God allowed us to go through Joshua chapter 5 last week to this week. Today, the Lord God allowed us to be in Joshua chapter 6 to hear what thus says the Lord. The Lord God inspired Joshua to write for us, for our hearing, for our guidance, to help us. Amen. And the campaign to capture Canaan took place in three stages. Yes, talking about Jericho. The campaign to capture Canaan took place in three stages. First, the Israelites cut the land in half from east to west, capturing the strategic towns of Jericho and Ai. And you can find that in chapters 6 through 8 of Joshua. And two, the Israelites defeated an alliance of the Amorite kings in the south and took their cities. You can find that in chapter 9 and 10 of Joshua. Three, the Israelites captured the northern part of the country by defeating an alliance of pagan tribes under the leadership of the king of Hazor. And that is found in chapter 11 of the book of Joshua. Amen. So, now, let's get down to the fall of Jericho. Yes, we know the song. We heard the verses. We heard the words. The fall of the walls of Jericho come tumbling down. Now let's hear what the Lord inspired Joshua to write about it. Verse 1 reads, "Now the gates of Jericho were securely barred because of the Israelites. No one went out and no one came in. Then the Lord said to Joshua, 'See, I have delivered Jericho into your hands, along with its kings and its fighting men. March around the city once and all with all the armed men. Do this 6 days. Have 7 priests carrying trumpets of ram's horns in front of the ark. On the 7th day, march around the city 7 times with the priests blowing the trumpets. When you hear the sound of alarm blasts on the trumpets, have the whole army give a loud shout. Then the wall of the city will collapse and the army will go up, everyone straight in. Let me pause right there. Now, God assured Joshua that Jericho was already delivered into his hands. God's strategy for capturing Jericho was unique. Yes. For 6 days, they were to march in silence around the walls of Jericho and return to camp. On the 7th day, they were to circle the city 7 times. At the completion of the 7th circle, as the trumpet sounded, the Israelites were to shout, and the Jericho walls would collapse and fall. Yes. Speaking of Jericho, Jericho was found thousands of years before Joshua was born and was one of the oldest cities in the world. Some of the areas, the walls were up to 25 feet tall and 20 feet thick. Jericho was a symbol of military power, and the Canaanites considered it unbeatable. Yes, they considered the Canaanites considered that Jericho was unbeatable because of its high walls and how thick the walls were. But it could not compete with the Lord God's power. Yes. Could not compete with God's power. Let's move on to verse 6. So Joshua, son of Nun, called the priests and said to them, take up the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord and have 7 priests carrying trumpets in front of it. And he ordered the army, advance, march around the city, and an armed guard going ahead of the Ark of the Lord. When Joshua had spoken to the people, the 7 priests carrying the 7 trumpets before the Lord went forward, blowing their trumpets, and the ark of the Lord's covenant followed them. The armed guard marched ahead of the priests who blew the trumpets, and the rear guard followed the ark. All this time the trumpets were sounding. But Joshua had commanded the army, do not give a war cry, do not raise your voices, do not say a word until I tell you to shout. Then shout. So he had the Ark of the Lord carried around the city, circling it once. Then the army came to the camp and spent the night there. Verse 11, so he had the Ark of the Lord carried around the city, circling it once. Then the army returned to the camp and spent the night there. Joshua got up early the next morning, and the priests took up the Ark of the Lord. The 7 priests carrying the trumpets went forward, marching before the Ark of the Lord and blowing the trumpets. The armed men went ahead of them, and the rear guard followed the Ark of the Lord, while the trumpets kept sounding. On the second day, they marched around the city once and returned to the camp. They did this for 6 days. On the 7th day, verse 15, on the 7th day, they got up at daybreak and marched around the city 7 times in the same manner, except that on that day, they circled the city 7 times. The seventh time around, when the priest sounded the trumpet blast, Joshua commanded the army, "Show, for the Lord has given you the city." Amen. Amen. Let me pause again. What a mighty God we serve. And on that day, God's will and Israel's obedience were in perfect harmony. God's will and Israel's obedience were in perfect harmony. This plan, this perfect plan was shaped on set on the number seven. Yes. Seven priests, seven trumpets, marched around Jericho 7 days, marched around Jericho seven times on the seventh day. Yes, yes. Think about it. Let's move on down to verse 17. The city and all that is in it are to be devoted to the Lord. Only Rahab, the prostitute, and all who are with her in her house shall be spared. Because she hid the spies we sent. Yes. Yes. Verse 18. But keep away from the devoted things, so that you will not bring about your own destruction by taking any of them. Otherwise, you will make the camp of Israel liable to destruction and bring trouble on it. All the silver and gold and articles of bronze and iron are sacred to the Lord and must go into his treasury. When the trumpet sounded, the army shouted, and at the sound of the trumpet, when the men gave a loud shout, the wall collapsed. So everyone charged straight in and they took the city. They devoted the city to the Lord and destroyed with the sword every living thing in it. Men and women, young and old, cattle, sheep, and donkeys. Joshua said to the two men who spied out the land, "Go into the prostitute's house and bring her out and all who belongs to her, in accordance with your oath to her." So the young men who had done this spying went in and brought out Rahab, her father and mother, her brothers and sisters, and all who belonged to her. They brought out her entire family and put them in a place outside the camp of Israel. Then they burned the whole city and everything in it. They put the silver and gold and articles of bronze and iron in the treasury of the house of the Lord's house. Yes. Verse 24 again. They burnt the whole city and everything in it. But they put the silver and gold and articles of bronze and iron into the treasury of the Lord's house. Amen. But Joshua spared Rahab the prostitute with her family and all who belonged to her, because she hid the men Joshua had sent as spies to Jericho. And she lives among the Israelites to this day. At that time, Joshua pronounced this solemn oath. "Cursed before the Lord is the one who undertakes to rebuild this city, Jericho. At the cost of his firstborn son, he will lay his foundations. At the cost of his youngest, he will set up his gates." So the Lord was with Joshua. Verse 27. So the Lord was with Joshua, and his fame spread throughout the land. Amen. Amen. That concludes the reading of Joshua chapter 6, verse 1 through 27. And Joshua and the Israelites followed God's instructions, and the walls of Jericho fell down. Yes, say that again. Joshua and the Israelites followed God's instructions, and the walls of Jericho fell down. The total population of Jericho was destroyed except Rahab and her family. Her family was spared, just like the spies promised her when she protected them. Rahab became the, Rahab, the prostitute. Rahab became the great-great-grandmother of King David. We know King David. Rahab became the great-great-grandmother of King David and an ancestor of Jesus Christ. The Lord God can use anyone for his purpose. Amen. The Lord God can use anyone for his purpose. God was punishing Jericho because of the wickedness of the Canaanites. Now, and also the Israelites were to destroy everything in Jericho except the silver and gold and the bronze objects. These objects were to be set aside for the Lord's treasury. No individual could keep the spoils alone or war. Yes. The iron, the silver, gold, and bronze objects were to be set aside for the Lord's treasury. And no one, no individual could keep the spoils of war. And the Canaanites, yes, God was punishing Jericho because of the wickedness of the Canaanites. Yes, and Joshua cursed anyone who tried to rebuild the city of Jericho. That curse was fulfilled in 1 Kings chapter 16, verse 34. Look it up. Be like the Bereans. Look it up. Look it up. 1 Kings chapter 16, verse 34. When a man named Hiel rebuilt Jericho and lost his oldest and youngest sons. Yes. Yes. Joshua cursed anyone who tried to rebuild the city of Jericho. Amen. Amen. That concludes this Bible study. Let us pray. Heavenly Father God, once again we come to thank you, Lord, for your love, your grace, and your mercy. Lord God, we thank you for your words that you have written and inspired men to write for our reading, for our hearing, for us to be guided by. Lord God, we are reminded of how you have helped your people in the past. And Lord God, we are grateful that you are helping us now. We thank you, Lord, knowing that you are God that can do any and everything. And Lord God, we pray that we will stay in your will, that we will stay in harmony with you, that we will keep your words upon our hearts and sin not against you, Lord. But to go out and tell someone else about you, to share you with others, that they may call on you, Lord God, to be saved. Lord God, we just pray that you continue to be with us, that your spirit lead us and guide us in the way that we should go, Lord God. Lord God, we know that only you can heal us, Lord. Lord, we have failed many, many times, but with you, we are made perfect, Lord God. We just thank you, Lord, for being with us, for looking after us, for giving us shelter, for feeding us, Lord God. We just thank you for everything you've done for us, Lord. Lord God, you give us the sunshine. You give us the rain. And Lord God, most of all, you protect us for any element that's out there, for all our diseases, for all our sickness, all our hurts and pain. It's you that's there to comfort us, Lord. And Lord God, we're going to continue to call on you every day of our life, Lord God. We just thank you so much, Lord. Thank Lord God, we ask you this prayer in the name of Jesus. Amen. 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 Thank you, Lord.